a Gooch Show, everybody. Happy Tuesday.
Happy Tuesday.
This is a great show, and want to let you know right from the beginning that usually we try to tone the language down. Tonight, we're not toning anything
tonight
down.
We do what we want.
We do what you have children?
Fuck it.
All right. I thought we were going to wait a little fucking while.
Well, it happens, you know.
Shit happens.
Shit happens when you party naked.
When you party naked. Speaking of partying, right now it's a little slow in comedy, so people are having more
fun.
Oh,
I thought you were talking about partying because I've been drinking all day.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to mention. You were at a...
I was at a clam shucking contest earlier today, and my dad was in a competition. He was shucking clams, and he was also buying me beers, so... What happens tonight stays here, and
don't
then
tell
it goes
nobody.
To the rest of you. We're doing what we want here on the Gooch Show.
We're having fun. I'm wearing a crown.
Benny's
crowning. I'm crowning.
Yeah.
Yes.
He is the Burger King, the king of burgers.
I'm hoping if I wear this, you know, Burger King will say, let's sponsor the Gooch Show or sponsor Madhouse TV.
That would be amazing. I don't think they will, though.
I mean,
they're probably not watching us. They're probably like... Why is that guy with the what?
He's embarrassing us. He's embarrassing Burger King.
Can you please take that crown off? Can you please? No, yeah. That's what Burger King said.
Yeah, you want me to. And we have another Gagoots.
Wow.
Looks like a question mark.
Looks like a dick.
You wish.
Do.
You do.
Yeah, that's our Gagoots show.
I'm going to cook that one.
Great.
That's our show. We have guests. We've been forgetting to
mention.
Oh,
we have those.
We have guests on tonight's show. We have, if you've been watching the show, you know we do shout-outs to Mike Dillon.
All the time.
All the time. Mike Dillon is in the house.
Woo! Woo!
And Joe Curry, who was here a few weeks ago, is back.
Returned for his title, you know. Undefeated champion of the Gagoots Show. Anyway, we're going to bring our guests on a little later on. In the meantime, we want to talk about a couple of hot topics we have. Obviously, Donald Trump is, like, big in the news right now.
I love what he's doing. I love him.
I like what he's doing, but me and Stephen Perillo, who you guys may have remembered, were talking about this the other night at the diner, and we're like, did you watch the debate when he's like, none of my companies went bankrupt. Nothing has gone bankrupt. And the lady was like, the guy was like, blah, 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 blah. And like called him out and he's like, what am I saying? Like, what are you saying? I don't know anymore. Like, do you know? You don't obviously know what you're saying. I don't know either. Like, it was just very awkward. But I still like him.
I like him too because one of the things he goes overboard. He does go overboard. But he says... you people are talking about things you were never going to mention.
Right.
And I think, you know, he's a true patriot. He is a patriotic American.
I agree that he's patriotic, but don't you feel like people, like Americans, are like, oh, it's a name, it's familiar, it's popular, it's something going on, like, let's tune into this now. Like, if Donald Trump wasn't in the running of presidency, like, I don't feel like America would be as involved right now, unless you were like a hardcore Democrat or Republican, like because people mind my generation of group, like from what I remember from the last two elections with Obama, like I would try to talk to my friends about politics. Nobody knew what was going on. I would be like, you don't know anything that what he stands for, what he's looking to do, anything. No, I'm like, okay, this one everybody's chitter chatter about Trump, and it's like at least he's bringing awareness to people who didn't look at politics before and say, you know, I don't care, who knows. Well, at least people are paying attention.
Yes, they are, and that's a good thing, because the country is in trouble, as he's saying.
Right.
We're in trouble. The country, it's broken. Somebody has to come in and fix the country. And all these other politicians for years, all they were doing was slinging mud. Oh, this other, the person running against me, did this and that, and they're no good. And the other one is doing the same. Oh, they're no good.
Right.
But they're not telling you what they stand for. Or they tell you change. We have a man right now that said change. And the only thing, the change is for the worse.
Right.
The country's in the shitter.
It pretty much has been. But I'm looking forward to keep watching what's going to happen from this. I mean, he full on was like, told some lady that she was being a bitch because she was PMSing. I mean, I mean, there's women out there that took really offense to that. I was like, you know what? Sometimes you got to call it like it's season. I mean, I don't have any boyfriends anymore, probably due to my BMS, but, you know, whatever. At least, you know, they come out and they say, hey, this is what's happening. You're being a bitch right now. And you're like, all right. And I heard her come back onto the radio and the news, and she was like, well, you know, I don't take offense to what he said. And she was kind of cool about it, so maybe she was really BMSing.
And but also, a lot of people who are pro-Republican, the right-wingers, they feel that he's messing things up for them.
Right.
That no one's taking the Republicans seriously. But we are.
Right.
We really are. Because we're looking at, after Trump said something, we want to hear the response of all these other guys. And there was a few people that
there
I thought,
a lot of people.
Right off the bat, that I don't want this guy being my president. There was a few that I thought, you know, I'd like to hear. But I feel Trump is not full of crap.
He says what's on his mind. He doesn't care. You know what? He's got nothing to lose. He loses the election, okay, he's still a billionaire.
And he brought awareness to the election.
Exactly.
For young people, for everybody.
I would totally agree with that, 100%. That for some, my generation of group 28 to like 25 to 30, we're aware of like what's going on. Like you're interested in what's going on. Maybe you needed a celebrity face to be on it, but what he says isn't lying, you know? He says it like it is, so, okay, peace. You know.
And he's had a lot of corporations. Man. He's always doing something new to, and he's, you know, to boost the economy.
Yeah, but, whatever, enough about Trump. I'm tired
all right, of him. All right, we're tired of him. What else?
he's like, enough tired, Trump.
Enough Trump. Everybody's great. Talking about Trump. We talk about comedy. You did a
you
show.
You
want
to talk about comedy on a comedy show?
On a comedy
show. On our show about comedy? You want to talk about comedy?
Yeah.
What a great idea!
What a concept! Pretty much, this was the diner, the first meeting with Nicole and I when we first met and we were at a diner. And I said, I want to have a talk show and I want you to sit next to me.
Here I am.
And we will both be hosts of that show. And that's what happened. The Cocoon Show.
Oh, this show.
This show. Not another. We'll start another show.
Maybe one day.
One day, yeah.
I don't know what we'll call it, though.
I don't know. She's whispering. We need another beer. You did a show Wednesday.
I did.
Open for Paul Bond.
I did.
A great show at On the Waterfront.
On the Waterfront. It was awesome. We had a great time. There was a nice turnout. Paul Bond rocked the house, as always.
Oh, if you haven't seen Paul Bond yet.
He's amazing.
He's amazing.
He's just like a firecracker. He just doesn't give a shit. He just doing what he does. And he's a big, big supporter of the Donald Trump. Stirring the pot. That's what he's doing. And that's what he loves. But yes, he's fantastic. And we had Mike Keegan on the show, myself. Americo, who hosted, Richie Ragu, and Pat Marone.
And Joe Capella.
And Joe Capella, yeah.
Joe Capella.
Was Pat Marone there?
Pat Marone wasn't
Pat
on
Marone
this.
Pat Marone was there.
He
was there the last time.
The last time. The last Paul Bond show.
And no, he was there. Yes, he was there.
No, he wasn't there.
Oh, no. Joe Capella was there.
Joe Capella was there.
You're right.
Were you there?
Now, something happened to you. Your performance, they loved you so much that Paul Bond is coming back October 7th. I'm hosting, and they said Nicole has to come back. So you're coming back.
Amazing.
And I guess Mike.
I'm coming back like three Terminators, man. I'll be back. On the waterfront. Rubber baby buggy bumpers. I don't know.
Now, you were doing your act. Mm-hmm. And somebody came over and threw like $30 worth of singles at you?
It was $19.
$19?
I wish it was $30 because I would have took that extra couple of bucks. But it was $18 or $19. And I was doing my act. And I'm pretty sure I was doing my bit about how I have autism. So it really wasn't sexy at all. And this guy was just like making it rain on me.
Yeah.
And I didn't have to twerk or take my clothes off or anything. All I had to do was pretend that like something was handicapped with myself. I wish that's how it worked all the time because I would be loaded. But You know, I'm not, but yeah, that was cool. So I made like $18.
That's
being great. On the waterfront. I had like gas money to get there, so that was cool.
I remember I looked and all of a sudden there's this money raining
money
on
everywhere.
You. And you're like, I don't know what the hell happened, but I'll take it.
I'll take it. And he didn't laugh at anything. The guy just like, he was mad at me. He was like, he was mad at throwing his money at me. He was just like. Like, making this face, like, he was just so upset with my moves, and I was like, thank you. I don't know, it was really awkward.
But I made money,
and whatever.
It was funny, and it was a great show.
It was a great show. I had a good time. So.
You did,
and you
yeah.
and Nancy were there supporting us.
Yeah, Nancy and I came down, because it's usually, it's Ryan's birthday week.
Right.
So when he was younger, like, my whole vacation week would be with it. But this time, He spent it with,
hang out with Kevin Smith.
On his birthday,
Clerks,
yeah.
Clerks.
And they
James
did it.
Bob.
Right. Mallrats.
Mallrats.
And they did a Q&A with Kevin Smith, and then he got taken away, like, with a security, and Ryan went running after him and yelled, Kevin, you were my Comic-Con moment. And we talked about that on the show
where
Kevin Smith had hugged him at Comic-Con.
Yeah.
So Kevin called him over and they took a picture together.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
That must have made his birthday. He's a huge fan.
Yeah, yeah. And then they watched Mallrats. Mallrats played outdoors. They played in Brooklyn.
Did you watch it with him?
No, he did the Q&A before it. Ryan got to hug him again.
That's nice.
And then he watched Mallrats with his friends.
Cool. And you're going to watch more of us after we take this break right now.
And we're going to show a clip of the late, great Phyllis Diller.
You'll be right back, and we'll be right back. You're watching The Good Show on MadHouseTV.com.
Thank you very much. You think I'm overdressed? This is my slip. I got a figure that just won't start. My body's in such bad shape, I wear prescription underwear. I finally had a ship tattooed on my chest. I wanted something on it. Would you believe that I once entered a beauty contest? I must have been out of my mind. I not only came in last, I got 361 get well cards. I don't want you to get the idea that I have given up on my looks. I will never give up. I am in my 14th year of a 10-day beauty plan. When I go to bed at night, I've got so much grease on my body, I wear snow chains to hold up my gown. We've got more grease stains in the bedroom than we got in the garage. One night, I asked Fang to kiss me goodnight. He got up and put on his work clothes. You know, the lights have gone out with dirty old Fang. The last time there was a gleam in Fang's eye, there was a short in his electric blanket. All he cares about is football. I thought that our weekends after we were married would be a loaf of bread, a jug of wine, and love. You know how it turned out? A box of pretzels, a can of beer, and the Green Bay Packers. You wouldn't believe the way this man boozes. He can kill a six-pack during an instant replay. His breath is so bad, the dentist works on him through his ears. He's such a coward, when I take him to the dentist's office, they have to strap him in the chair, give him a shot of Novocaine, and a balloon. That's in the waiting room.
Stop the truck! name is Dr. Robert Brevard. I'm here for Multimedicine in Westbury, New York. We're located at 1065 Old Country Road, Suite 214. Been here for about 15 years. The practice has medical doctors, physical therapists, chiropractors, acupuncturists. We also do pain management, and we have orthopedists on staff. Here at Advanced Multimedicine Rehabilitation, we've got physical therapists on staff who treat an array of conditions, from neck pain to back pain, shoulder pain. We treat carpal tunnel. We treat a lot of car accident patients, slip and falls. We treat patients with knee injuries, with ankle injuries. We have state-of-the-art equipment. We've been here for over 15 years. We do a vast array of diagnostic testing, from x-rays to EMGs. What is an EMG? It's a diagnostic test that allows a doctor to determine where the pinched nerve is. Cora is a physical therapist at Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation. She's working on Stephanie, who was involved recently in an automobile accident. Stephanie has tight thoracic and cervical musculature, and Cora is doing some myofascial release work and some therapeutic stretching doing it to help her with her pain. Vicky is also a patient here at Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation. Vicky is now working her leg muscles, specifically her quadricep muscles, trying to strengthen them after an injury she sustained. Find yourself in need of any type of physical therapy, please don't hesitate to call Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation, located in Westbury, New York, in Suite 214. Phone number is 516-334-7000, or find us on our website at advancedmultimedicine.com.
On the Gagooch Show with our first guest, Mike Dillon.
Hi, Mike Dillon's finally here.
He made it.
Where is he?
Where'd he go?
Where'd
he go? Half of him is gone.
Half of me is gone. Yeah, half will be gone next week. Nice to finally be here after a year. Congrats.
We're not a year yet.
I heard it was a year. You lied to me already. You're already lying.
No, October the 1st.
It's almost a year.
It's almost.
Wow, I think that's great. Plus, you guys.
Thank you. Thank you. This is our 11th month.
And Jeannie, too. Jeannie Palliser was great. Yeah. On your show when she filmed.
She was fun. Yeah, Jeannie. Great.
We got to have her back again soon.
We will. Since we mentioned her, Jeannie Powers is going to be in a play in Northport, Long Island. Comedy play. And she's called The Waiting Room.
Okay.
And it's at the Bare Bones Theater. In Northport.
Cool. That's
so
great.
I gotta go see it.
It opens in September. She just started rehearsing.
That's awesome, Jeannie. Congratulations.
Yep. I told her, and she's like, I never did acting before. She says, but the director says he wants me because of my comedic timing. And I told her, you're a natural actor.
Yeah, she's so funny.
She is. So
she's hilarious.
Well, how about back to me now? Enough with Jeannie.
Yeah,
well,
you're bringing up.
All right.
I hobble here. From wherever the hell I'm living these days. Well, Joe, where am I? Your house tonight. Yeah. Medford. To get on this show. All right, go ahead.
I'm sorry. In Medford. Mike, you've been stand-up comedian on Long Island for 15 years.
That's right, 15.
For 13 years, you've been a producer of comedy shows.
Lucky 13.
And you've been running Gateway Comedy.
Actually, I've been wheelchairing Gateway lately. And then we're walking, except the last couple of days, I'm finally walking.
For those, Mike Dillon only has one leg.
Great news! I didn't know that. I actually,
Some people don't know.
How can I stand if I only have one leg? Nicole,
he's got one real leg.
One leg, really? Is that an insult to what, Joe?
The other leg, he stole off of Arnold Schwarzenegger.
I just started walking again. It's an amazing thing.
You are amazing. I'm being a jerk right now. It is amazing. Don't say that because what you've gone through, you are very inspirational to a lot of people. And everybody who reads your Facebook is like, look at this guy.
What the hell is this guy doing now?
You're getting through life like the rest of us, the way you have to do it. And it's awesome that you're inspiring.
Like I was telling you guys before in the green room, you know, I was brought up a certain way. You don't depend on people. You don't depend on doctors. You don't depend on shrinks. And for good or bad, I actually think it was for the worst. I would never, ever tell anybody to do what I did. But it's you know, like I said, it's my legacy. My father was like a World War II.
It's his legacy.
If it's just your father's, not considered, it has to be like three for a legacy.
Legacy.
Listen, that's it right there.
Hey!
End of the show. But anyway, it was a legacy. It was a legacy.
What a friggin' war.
You know, my father, I'm more, I don't remember. But I was a little hot, actually. But my father was a World War II Marine, and he was a kid. He didn't even graduate high school. And like, God, he was so, never said a word, never told you how to act or behave, but you just had to watch him. And the man was as strong as anybody I've ever met. And it's something that I have to live with. It's something that to carry on my name. And by the way, I'm having a grandson soon who's going to carry on the family name. And he'll be another idiot Dylan.
Yay!
Out there. Going through life without, you know, the proper way, you know, without doctors or therapists or anything else, like an idiot like me.
So this will be your first grandson to bear the Dylan name.
Isn't that amazing, Timmy, my son is having his baby, and
what's his name gonna be?
Be strange, the first guy actually to have a baby, but you know.
What are they gonna name the baby?
We're hoping Timothy, or after my father Thomas Francis, but they're not gonna.
All right.
But
that's great. I know.
I'm sweating.
It's very hot.
You come from a big Irish family, and you have a great. Tim, I remember him when he was little, helping you.
Yeah, so do I. I haven't seen him in 7 years now. My wife, I could kill her. I could strangle her. She never lets me see my son. Betty, what kind of a.
It's good to see
I'm so
you.
Stupid,
know,
right?
2 weeks ago, a couple of weeks ago, I
was
saw you.
I was crying outside. I was in the beer. I wasn't walking. I couldn't drive.
You were in a wheelchair.
Right. Oh,
and then, and you know me, I give you sympathy. Like, if you want sympathy from me, you'll find it in the dictionary between shit and syphilis. So I remember. I was there. So then I went to an open mic last week, Nicole, at the Lizard Lounge. I'm saying hi to Nicole, to Stephen. And then I walk by the bar, and you're sitting there.
Why not? It's a Tuesday night.
And I was used to seeing you in
a
wheelchair.
I'm sweating a little. I hope you don't. Oh, yeah, I'm in a wheelchair, right?
And then you were sitting there, and you said, I was waiting to see how long it would take you to ride. I didn't realize it.
Well, I just started walking a couple of days ago. I'm still falling. I'm not supposed to walk. You know, they told me, don't you walk. You're too dangerous. You're too dangerous. I used to, I'm going on vacation 2 weeks. You better not walk in those 2 weeks. I said, I'm walking, and I've been walking. You know, a couple of close calls. One would have been great if somebody had a camera. It was great. I must have fell for 7 or 8 seconds, and I finally got to the car and fell on the car. But it was, I was like, it was unbelievable. It was so funny.
Oh,
and, you know, obviously scary, but in hindsight, it was so funny.
Well, you have to keep laughing at stuff like this. Otherwise, I mean, you just drive yourself crazy.
Yeah. Well, you know, I was given. You know, they told me, and I told you in the green room again. You know, people say, you know, you have a choice. You can sit there and just bemoan what's happened to you, or you can keep living your life. And the doctor said the same thing to me. And, you know, I said, fuck you, I'll do whatever I want. In fact, I'm going to jump off this building in 5 minutes. But what am I going to do? I mean, I thank God. If anything comes out of this, I thank God that I've gotten these many years with, you know, 2 legs. And I still got 1 leg, and most of it anyway. And, you know, I'm getting along, and I'm driving now, and I'm walking. I got news for you. When you don't walk for like a year, I mean, you want to kick so many people that you hate in the ass because you haven't been able to stand up and do
it. It's literally impossible.
I'm glad I fed you that. And Joe Curry's laughing. Thank God. So, I know they never laughed at me when I did stand-up. But, you know, my son, everybody, stand up with me. I was done. I managed a couple of people now. Can't get out of my blood. It kills me that I couldn't physically do it. I couldn't physically get on stage. My son dared me I'm big on dares. I'm a stupid Irishman. You dare me to do something, guess what?
It's happening.
It's going to happen. He dared me to that. He's a New York City police officer now. So it's going to happen. I don't know when it's going to happen, but I'm going to have to do it just for that because I can't show him fear. I hate fear. It's worse than any four-letter word you can come up with, as far as I'm concerned, and I will not live in fear. I've been through a lot of fearful situations, but you want to know something? I've never addressed it with fear. I've always addressed it with... I remember years ago when I first started doing comedy, I was speaking with another comic who... I don't even remember who it was, and somebody came up and he said, you're amazing, because most people run away from what they're afraid of. You guys run towards it. You know, it's like a fireman. You know, like a fireman or a cop or somebody in a war. I mean, come on. I ran into a friend called me today. He's on one of your shows coming up at my place on the 21st, and he was in the 101st Airborne in Vietnam. He says, Mike, I'm more afraid of this than I was of that.
Really?
And I said to him, I said, don't make me come over there and slap you. Don't you ever equate war with stand-up comedy. Don't you ever. Nothing like war.
It's much harder.
And now for a joke. No, but I mean, really. I mean, people always say battles and like football games. We were in a war together. Please. Come on. I never was in a war, but guess what?
Me neither.
And you know what I mean? I've had a gun pointed at my head, stuff like that. Believe me, there's nothing like
But that was
that.
Your honeymoon.
That was my honeymoon. And she did pull the trigger, by the way, and that's why.
You know, I want to say, your wife,
you know, actually, that's why I lost the leg. That's how I lost the leg. She shot me the fucking leg.
Yeah, because you complain. Donna's a saint.
Donna is not a saint.
And you
is not here tonight.
You
Donna
off,
is not here tonight.
If she shot you in the leg, being
you know, I've heard
Sicilian.
The other joke, pull on my leg, you that joke. Go ahead, I literally mean it. Pull it. If you can. Keep going. Hey, that hurts, though. No. Wait, I'm serious, pull on it. Pull,
you really that, like,
pull on it now.
I just pull
on my finger, they say, right? There it is. That's what I walk around with now, folks.
Don't give it back.
But, you know, the beauty is, look at this.
Ain't that a kick in the head?
Yes. The beauty is, I'm so strong now, Joe Curry, coming on soon. Watch me fall over.
Yeah.
Look at this.
On live TV, hey, we'll probably get a million hits. Go
yeah,
for
live
it.
TV. But, come on, what are you going to do?
She's going to drink champagne out of that. We'll fill this up with
you're
beer.
You're going to make fun of this. That's
I'm
going to cry, right?
I'm going to shove it. I'm going to put beer in it, drink
yes,
out
yes.
of it.
Yes, well, yes. We use it like as a flower thing.
I like that. There could be a flower pot if you wanted to. There's a bugger on the wall. You just
I can
kill
change
it.
Shoes without even,
without
you know.
Having to bend over.
Oh, exactly. You could dry out. You could go to a shoe store. That would be the coolest thing. Go well, to a shoe store and tell
what, the size?
What I want to do, Benny and Nicole, beautiful Nicole, by the way, and the hair is different again. I like it. I want to go into one of these Asian pedicurist places and ask for a pedicure and have them take the shoe, because I have no toes on the left foot.
Oh, man.
Because
no.
They had to cut those off. You know, that was another great medical decision I made, you know, who I went to this guy. Oh, we take your toes. Then you take your money.
Was it a
go ahead, do it. Do it. Go ahead. What do I
call? Was it a two-for-one deal?
It was a two-for-one. How could I do it?
We
so
take
all
toes,
the toes
we,
are gone.
We do the leg at price.
So I would love for you guys to film that. I go into a Korean place and ask for a pedicure with the two
hilarious.
Legs. And then when she takes the shoes off... Oh, Misha, you have no toe.
You have nothing.
You have no toe. Well, then it's 100% off, isn't it? I get a discount.
Nicole, you wanted to make a comedy video for our contest. I
that
think
needs to be it. We
gotta
need
be
to go
stupidest
to...
stupidest thing you've had in this show.
A,
outside of me, it's pouring water.
We need to go to a nail salon and get...
Oh, all right.
I think it'd be funny?
I thought you were going to say we need to go to a commercial break.
Well, we could do that, too.
That guy, this was a
I just
want to
keep
shirt.
Playing with this leg. It's like a weight.
Like a gum on the...
It's
yes,
pretty
it
heavy.
Is. You can, it
you
is.
Know?
It's different. I got news for you. It's different.
Working out here on the Gooch Show with Mike Dillon's leg. We'll be right back. We're going to take a break now.
Yeah, I made a commercial for my nephews.
Hi, I'm Tatiana, and I'm a person in long-term recovery from heroin addiction. It was really, really hard, waking up in the morning, not knowing what to do, needing my next bag. I was so lost, but I'm here today to tell you that there is a solution. When I was in my active addiction, I didn't realize that there was another way of life. I thought that that was the only way, because it felt so good to get high, but it was all an illusion, and I didn't realize that. But today, being 4 years clean and sober, my life is absolutely amazing. I'm able to travel. I don't need a drink. I don't need a drug. I'm just happy being with myself. I couldn't understand for many years why. Why was I doing this? It's because I was an addict, but I didn't know it. Today, many kids are becoming addicted to drugs and alcohol, but they don't know exactly what they're getting into until they're out of it. And it's our job, it's my job, to stand for these kids, stand for their recovery, and fight for their addiction. So I'm the president of Onward Forever, and I provide recovery services and support. And we're here to help. We're here to just listen. Anything that we can do to help. If you need me, this is how you get a hold of me. Please call 347-244-1550. 347-244-1550. I developed this company to help you, our families, and our community to fight this crisis on Long Island and in our nation. Thank you.
Stretching under sedation or manipulation under anesthesia is a very gentle, very precise procedure to very slowly release any scar tissue that is formed as a result of a traumatic injury. Many people ask, how does this work? Will I get hurt? Will you stretch me too far? We only stretch the body part to its normal range of motion. After completing the post-MUA rehabilitation program, it's very common that our patients say to us, hey, I can play ball with my kid again. Hey, I can bowl again. Hey, I can enjoy hiking again. This is what makes it rewarding to us as practitioners.
And we're back on the Good Job.
I didn't get it out. Yeah. We're back on the Gagoot Show with Joe Curry.
Hello.
And Mike Dillon.
Did you guys call each other?
And are you kidding? 15 years.
Oh, yeah. Well,
you guys match.
We match today. We
color coordinated.
Yeah,
I got news for you. You guys said Joe Curry's on the show. I'm telling you, really, I couldn't have thought of, you know, anybody more than I'd like to be on the show with. First time for me, but Joe, great.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you'll be back.
You like that?
I'd say it matches me, and it's the Archie Bunker chair.
Yeah.
Hey there, read it there. Get me a beer there.
George, what a change.
Just leave it there, read it. All right there. Bonnie, I'm taking your dog off my lawn there. Why is there a leg there with flowers there?
That's my leg.
She doesn't. That's a good eater. Do it. Come on.
How Archie. You. Josh, what a jay!
You did it back, you did.
He's great at characters.
I like this. I'm going to take it home and plant it in my garden.
The only part of me you're allowed to take home, by
Yay!
The way. Very hard to get. I play very hard to get.
Mike's
it works too good.
You'll be easy actually to catch good without the leg.
Yes, it is. I've been told by the police department in New York County.
Robo Mike.
Robo Mike.
I thought that was funny. The leg. Mm.
It's very funny, and before we go to a break again, we're going to see what's under the, what's behind the sneaker.
You're going to love it. Yeah. I guarantee you, folks, if you never watched this show at all, or any, if you turn it off, say, Mike Dillon, what the, I'm not, but watch this when this we take this thing apart.
But you got right such a great attitude, because, I mean, a lot, and we talked about it in the green room, that a lot of people will let it get you down.
You haven't seen my post lately on Facebook.
But look, I mean, you know,
you don't, Joe, you really, you would have the same. You just can't. You know, you either stop or you go.
He looks so good now. You look so good.
You haven't seen the x-ray.
Great.
You haven't seen the latest medical report.
You know what? I saw you from the fundraiser.
Right,
and
it
you
was
looked
right
all
away,
feeble and everything, and now
yeah,
you look good.
Terrible.
Besides having one leg that's a vase, you look in great shape. You're looking good, man.
It's because I'm in a lot better shape than you are, Joe. What do you
expect?
Well,
yes, you
out
are. You haven't seen
look
my doctor.
Look at you. You've gone to hell.
Oh,
for God's sake.
He's got to be healthy to hold up the parrot on his shoulder.
Exactly, the parrot. And I need the hat. I need the big hat.
Now, you wanted to tell us a story a little bit about how you guys know each other.
You know, it's really not a funny story, so fuck that. No. When I first started comedy, I started with Chris Williamson and Eric Tartaglione, who's doing great, by the way. Bob Tamke. I was in that kind of group of guys.
Those guys.
And I remember doing a show up in Port Jefferson. It was if I remember correctly, it was one of our bigger gigs. It was a fucking bakery. That's supposed to be a laugh.
Don't you laugh?
Anyway,
that's where
I'm
we
not
started.
Because we started in the same.
And the guys were like, "We're working with Joe Curry tonight." I said, "What the fuck is Joe Curry?"
No, yeah, really? Who's
look,
Joe Curry?
Look, no, but no. We're working with Joe Curry. Wait till you see this guy. And you want to know something? He
stunk
that night. He sucked. Like The point. Where's the point? Somewhere.
I know where the boss is.
The point is, this guy was great then. A couple of years before us started.
Yeah,
I got news for you. And he hasn't let up. This guy works.
Oh, he's great.
Every weekend, all over the country. If he's not doing stand up and getting nobody laughing at all,
yeah,
He's not only a great comic, he's a great musician.
Yeah.
This guy, every freaking weekend.
Well, I'm going through a divorce. There's a reason I was never
involved. No, I didn't want to bring that up. But seeing that you mentioned I'm dating your wife now.
Good. Tell her I said. Let me ask you a question.
I love
can you drive a U-Haul truck?
I'm bleeding into his time. I'm sorry.
No. It's all our time.
It's our time.
Like,
Joe Curry's great.
It's like Ridgemont High. This is our time.
So wait, what kind of band?
Oh, rock band. It's called Race Odyssey, and we're an original band. And we took a break for the summer, and we have a CD out. Go to Race Odyssey. Race Odyssey on Facebook. Check it out. We were supposed to go back in the studio and do a second album, but one guy left, key guy of the band. But we're going to rebuild it and stuff like that. So hopefully we'll be back in. I'm crossing my fingers we'll be back in January. The thing, we were supposed to be mixing the thing now, but that never, you know, fortunately things happen in life, you know, we couldn't get there, but we'll get it out.
What instrument?
Keyboard player. Also play in Rot Gut, which is a band with Anthony Cumia from the Anthony Cumia Show.
Right.
And, play with that. And
Well, you grew up with Anthony Cumia.
I grew up with him, yeah. And was my best friend on my way.
And one thing, Joe, did not mention that right arm of his?
Yeah.
Not only does he play keyboards with it, he can unscrew it. Unscrew your arm, Joe. This is the theme of the show. You have to have the
Andrew T.
body
special.
Part. Sorry, it's but Benny, take your head. Unscrew it. That's right.
Wait, right
Nancy keeps telling me
you
unscrew your
Nicole,
head.
Unscrew your breast.
Wow, now that I would pay money for.
What is this? Is this a zucchini? What is this thing?
That's a gagoots.
That's a gagoots?
This is a gagoots, really.
This is the show, Joe. What you want?
This is a gagoots show. This is an actual... It's an Italian, indigenous to Italy. It's like a
that's right.
A
and it's really cool. It's like, okay.
And I cook it. I make a stew out of it.
Really? That's okay. And
then his wife, Nancy, stew, uses the rest for whatever
reason. Yeah, Nancy puts batteries
know.
In the other
I
end.
You can't eat all of that in one
Nancy,
meal.
Nancy, I'm only kidding. We're kidding. I apologize. If any of your friends are watching, please tell them I'm
Look at this, I want peace when I get it all.
You yeah. said on the show tonight.
There's never peace.
No peace on this
show. Now Donna will just take your leg and hide it on you.
Oh, forget that. Please, don't bring that up. Yeah. Don't bring that name.
Okay. Do things get interesting without having a leg? With
yeah,
the
you know, I am, you know, I think I told you in the green room before, I'm probably about 7 times stronger than I was when before this all happened.
Right.
So that doesn't mean I last 7 times longer, though.
But you know what?
It means I got to hobble into the bed.
But if you're in a bedroom, there's nothing to support you on that side, so you're going to roll over.
I have my little people.
He's
going to
have
me.
A move now.
I have
yeah,
you got to
move.
I bring a bunch of midgets in there with me, and they pop me up.
We'll turn you this way, Michael. There you go. Shall we put on the leg, Michael?
You look, you do whatever you got to do. Let's face it. Come on. The time is running short. I got to have a little fun. I can't drink. I can't smoke. I can't gamble. I got to do something, Benny.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a funny thing. Drinking is fun thing about. Like, I'm going. I've got diabetes. I got
oh, yeah.
diabetes. This is the diabetes episode.
It is. It is
so they told me I can't drink. Thank God I quit smoking last year, but I can't. I can't. I got to watch.
You
what
smoked?
I
didn't even.
Oh, I smoked like a freight train. I remember that. Yeah, I took it up in 2007, and then I just quit last year. And I was
thank
like
God
cigars
you,
and stuff like that, and I was
thank
smoking
God.
Marlboro Blacks. Like a pack and a half a day.
Oh, I didn't even know there were black.
They call
yeah,
them
yeah,
black
yeah.
because
don't
that's what it does
here.
To your lungs.
But, you know, it's... but, I want to quit in cold turkey.
Yeah. Good for you, man. Exactly. I applaud that.
And my wife, Nancy. Nancy quit 4 years now.
I don't want to applaud.
You smoke?
And I enjoy
smoke
it.
Too, man.
Nicole!
I applaud you, but I don't applaud me.
You gotta want to quit. You have to say I don't want to smoke anymore.
I know.
You like smoking, smoke. You know?
I do. I like it.
That
I like
is it.
It.
Yeah.
I feel cool.
But haven't you seen the commercials?
It's not even about. No. I feel cool smoking.
Smoking is cool.
It
I don't
is.
Care what anybody
the
says. Smoking's not cool.
I know.
Yeah. That's the thing with people. Smoking's not cool. No, smoking is cool.
No, it's cool.
It's the cancer and the coughing is
that's not
cool. Yeah. But it looks. Smoking has always looked cool. It really
it has.
And everybody smoked because nobody likes the taste of smoking. They're out of their
right.
mind. But smoking looks cool. That's why everybody started. And
yep.
you always started in high school.
It's true.
You know, there's no mature girl, I'm going to smoke a butt now. No, no. You started when you were 16. You want to hang out in the back hall, puff butts, hang out.
Are we smoking? Are we talking about smoking butts or smoking cigarettes now,
smoking.
Joe? Because I don't smoke butts. I don't go anywhere near there.
Yes.
You don't know where that's been.
Yes.
And most of the time.
Well, we have an idea, but, you know, and with that knowledge, no.
On the show now, we've been showing clips of comedians who have passed away. And so we call it the late great. So we've had Flip Wilson.
Right.
And tonight we had Phyllis Diller.
Phyllis Diller. Both
with cigarettes.
Rodney yeah. Dangerfield.
Yeah. Rodney Dangerfield was the first. But Phyllis Diller and Flip Wilson had cigarettes. And
yeah.
they were on. Flip Wilson yeah. was on Johnny Carson. And
he
she was on Ed Sullivan. With the long cigarette
yeah,
holder.
Right.
Right.
I
want
to get
under
that. That was her cigarette.
Yeah, you could get those in a smoke.
Even about when we were kids, when your mother would be too lazy to go into the here's $5, go get a pack of Tarentins.
Right.
And you go in, it's like, I want to get a pack of Tarentins for my mother. There you go. And then keep the change. You get arrested now if you did
yeah.
that.
Yeah, you get arrested giving a kid.
You
know?
Can't let
yeah.
them keep the change like that, Joe.
All right.
What's the matter with you? It's money. Get your cigarettes, get your change,
oh, yeah.
and get the hell out.
But it's like, you know.
Cigarettes were 27 cents.
Right. Wow. They were 55 cents when I started. Yeah,
55 cents.
Yeah.
They were $5 when I started.
Oh,
wow.
Youngin.
Me and my friends would gather our change together, like legit quarters. And we would wait outside of 7-Eleven and wait for somebody who looked like they were 21 to buy us cigarettes. And we'd go, do you think you could? And then they'd be like, all right. Like, they were already annoyed with us that we asked. And then we'd pull out, like, a bag of quarters and be like, okay, here you go. Like, really? Are you kidding me?
You're actually to break the law, give minors cigarettes, and I got to go in like I got a paper route. Really?
Do yeah. That's right. That's exactly what happened.
And there you are, like, what, 14, 15, thinking
we got the thing.
Yeah, yeah, everything's cool. What's the problem?
We got wine coolers and we got butts. We're getting hammered tonight.
Wine pool. We used to go when we used to hang out in the woods by the abandoned car.
Boone's Farm.
Boone's Farm. Yeah, and that's like if girls were coming up, and it's like we go, you remember Orange Tango?
That.
We would like, get some Jack Daniels, a case of Bud, and we're entertaining tonight. Bring up some Tango.
I'm getting a dry heat.
I remember Tango, yeah.
Could you imagine, sir, you're having a dinner party at your house, you put out Boone's Farm?
Yeah, exactly. But we drank that stuff like it was $1
and
wine, and which it was. By the way, it was $1. Yeah. It was 99 cents.
Yeah.
College, I remember.
Ripple.
The day.
Yeah. You know, it was lovely. Was a lovely night. Abandoned car, fire.
You
know, woman dreams. Tango. Yeah. It's,
We used to go to Fire Island. Take the ferry to Fire Island.
You were one of those.
And
people?
Buy like the blackberry.
You like that? Betty, Fire Island.
Ocean Beach.
Not that.
Ocean Beach.
Not that there's anything wrong.
If you've watched the show, you know I used to be a bartender for 8 years on Fire Island. So I went all over. The only place I've never been to Davis Park. I never made a
Davis pass. Park. I was there. Davis Park. I think I was there.
You can never get your ass out of Cherry Grove if you know what I'm talking about.
You couldn't.
I got out of this scot-free.
So Joe, where are you playing? Let me intercede. Where are you performing in the next couple of weeks?
They would
get me plugged to this.
I'll be damned if I know.
Joe actually has a couple weeks off. He said.
Let's see. This week I'm seeing Van Halen on Saturday.
Great.
Jones Beach, right?
Yeah.
Cool. And you didn't invite me, of course.
Well, I almost wound up buying 4 tickets by accident because I only need one. But no.
Oh, you have any for sale?
I would have if I hit click.
Listen, we'll talk in a minute. We're going to take a quick break. You're watching The Gagoot Show with Joe Curry, Mike Dillon, and Nicole LaMonaco.
Mike Dillon's leg.
And Mike Dillon's leg.
Do we have to leave?
No, we're taking a break. We'll be right back. And we'll see what's behind the foot.
Yes.
Okay.
It's called the Big
Coach is a full-service limousine and party bus company. Family-owned and operated, we are an industry leader with over 25 years of experience in providing best-in-class luxury transportation for your special event. Whether it's your precious wedding day, an all-day wine tour out east, your high school prom, that special birthday, or just an amazing night on the town, our professional chauffeurs stand ready to ensure your special event is truly special. Galaxy Luxury Coach has one of the largest and modern party bus fleets in the New York area. Our party buses are simply nightclubs on wheels, concert sound systems, light shows, lasers and strobes, multicolor LED lighting brilliantly lights your party bus inside and out. For corporate and more laid-back events, we will cater to your specific needs and requests. What sets Galaxy aside from all others in the luxury transportation industry is our attention to detail in customizing our services to your special event. At Galaxy, it's all about you and your guests. Galaxy customers return time and time again because they know they can trust Galaxy to help deliver those lifetime memorable moments. Step aboard and let your Galaxy experience begin. Galaxy.
What are you looking for? You don't even know that. You're on the ball list, so you can't even answer. I'm asking you about it.
You gotta be highly skilled. You understand that? Are you well versed there? You very smart man. Hit me with some funny shit.
My shit's twisted.
Tell me something.
That's awesome.
Well,
that's a big.
That's nice.
That's awesome. Sir, are you interested in
twisted talent?
Yeah, I am.
I'm sure.
You guys twisted.
That's twisted.
You see what I'm saying? You understand me? And if you can't whip out answers like that, that man is liable to go on a commercial break, punch your fucking mouth loose. You understand me? Time is up, sir. You understand me? You're on. You're the man. All right, give me your name now. I'm sorry.
My name is Willie.
Willie, where are you working at?
We are Twisted. We are awesome. We are awesome. Love it. Awesome. Love awesome.
Can you repeat it?
And we're back with the Gagooch Show and Joe Curry.
Why?
And Rick Dillon.
Why?
Because you're having fun.
Of course I'm having fun. I love it.
We're this all having fun.
I love you guys. I watch every show you guys do. I really. Only I'm because glad. Nancy tells me I have to.
Yeah.
But, no,
Rick
I
Dillon's
do.
Like, I watch every I show. I had no idea that you were a bartender at Fire yeah. Island because you've mentioned it a thousand bajillion times.
A bazillion times.
And the other
exactly.
things he did at Fire Island behind the bar that he never told you about. But did I tell you I have a chauffeur now? Did I tell you that?
No, we're going to try to get him on.
I mean, I'm not allowed to drive.
You have a Jewish blowhorn?
Sorry. I wish.
Oh, yeah? Oh, all right. But we're going to put a camera on your chauffeur, but for the meantime, you have the suspense is building.
Well, take it
what
off.
What could be
take
in there?
I take the whole sneaker off the
go
way.
Go ahead. What the hell? What am I going to do with it?
This is a good one, Joe. I like
that.
He is, yeah.
Benny, it's an hour show. Come on, move it up. Mess it up.
Oh, my God. This is how he is.
Now, don't break it. It's the only way I got to get home.
When he runs his shows, that's how he is. Benny, hurry up.
Like he never took a sneaker off a foot before.
Wait a minute.
Like he never took a sneaker off a prosthetic
yeah, but not
foot.
Holy, yeah, really.
Come
yeah.
on, Ben. Cut it. Cut the lace.
This is
cut
not
me.
Sexy.
Cut the lace.
All right, now ooh. You take the sock. The sock is clean, by the way. You don't want anybody yeah. to go out. Now, take a look.
Ooh.
Now, show the nails. My granddaughter. My granddaughter wanted to paint the nails.
Where are we looking here?
This yeah, one. You got that?
Wow.
She wanted to paint this out. I knew you'd get a kick. I thought you'd laugh.
These are sexy toes.
Well, thank you. I finally impressed the ladies.
Don't do that. You're going to get a splinter.
Yeah, you're going to splinter.
All right, we'll okay. put it back on.
Is that pretty right. funny?
Well, that is hilarious. How
now,
do you...
what? Anyway. Now, the question is this. You take your thing off. You got a stake, a piece of metal. You know, it's great. You got that thing. And then why even have something that looks like a foot on the end? I mean, everybody is getting freaked out or grossed out.
So
or
your grandkids could paint it.
Oh, yeah, yes, exactly. Yeah. I mean, that's so stupid.
Somebody could anyway, go, thank God. Well, you need that on there.
Since I can't put this back,
yes.
we're gonna show your chauffeur who stays. So everyone knows Mike is leaving safely. We have a camera. Gonna put on your chauffeur.
Americo,
how you doing over there?
Hey, Nicole, how you doing? Benny, what's up, guys?
How's it going? We were talking about smoking, so I guess you wanted to light a cigarette up him.
Well, from what you tell me now, I got to put his foot together, but, you know, I can do that while I'm smoking, yeah, you know. He does that all the time while I'm driving.
He's great. Bad Chico's great.
Yeah?
Chico. Oh, my God.
Chico.
I walk into clubs, I constantly yell at Chico, Chico, get that fucking car started, quick!
We gotta get the hell out of here!
I just flirted with some guy's girlfriend!
Can't get that thing
I
back in the
show. I
physically
watch you do this. I mean, he's great. Get Chico back on. Get
there's, my an easy on to,
there.
There's an easy way to please. Do it.
Just, all right, we'll take care of
yeah,
it.
Yeah, there he is. This is my man.
Chico will do it later.
It involves vaseline and stuff.
Put it on the goddamn floor.
Well, Chico, thank you for saying what's up to us.
No problem, Nicole. Thank you guys for having me on the show. I love to drive.
Awesome.
I love to drive. And at least he doesn't have a turban.
Stop the fucking car! I'm sorry. I thought it was somewhere else.
Is that politically incorrect? You have a chauffeur who is an Indian?
I don't know how much political. I don't touch thought about that politically correct stuff.
Well, he's got the hat in the shade, so he's definitely got that.
He does things. All I can say, he does things.
He does things. Oh, yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about the things.
Mike, you want? I'll give you a cement shoe.
Yeah, right. I already got the shoe part.
We'll fix that after the show because yeah.
He's usually used to cement
Nicole's
shoes.
Nicole's going. She's like, I can't look at him doing that anymore.
Yeah, we gotta fix that later.
I'm one of those guys. I'm one of those people that if you watch me do something, you want to. You're like, get out of the goddamn way. I'm one of those people. I'm
oh
one
my.
Of those.
Yeah,
leave
I'm,
me alone. Don't bother. I'll do it. But
yeah.
And right. I hate the people that are like,
own time.
Come on, Benny. Come on, Benny. I hate those, because then I love, those people get so upset with me,
right.
that when they go to do it, they're like, fuck it. They can't do it now. They can't. Because, and then they have an excuse. I would have been able to do it if I didn't watch you doing it first. Because you don't know what the hell you're friggin' doing. So I'm one of those.
Benny. That's Benny.
That's what happened.
I do that when when the band plays. Like, we have a backdrop and we're hanging up the banner sign and stuff like that. Joe, help us out. And I'm like, I can't. What are you doing over there? I don't know.
No idea.
You asked me for help. Here I am.
We're putting up the banner for Gateway now, and the mentor, Mike, the mentor, is telling us how to do it.
Well, I've done it for years.
Yeah, his wife is like, I'd like to tell him where to stick
I've
this.
Actually had that stupid thing, like, cockeyed up there, and once somebody touched it, and the freaking thing fell down in the middle of the show. I mean, come on, you want to try to make it look as professional.
You put on a great show.
He came in and he was boss man. He's like, all right,
well,
this used to go here.
I do it. That's what I do.
Bring it up another foot. Bring it
that's
up another foot.
That's what I do. That's
there.
What I do.
He's like, you're taking notes, Nicole? I'm like, got it.
That's what I do. That's what I do. Especially since I wasn't walking. I was in the wheelchair then. So.
Yeah, you were. Yeah.
And we have a couple of shows that I want to mention. We have a show for Gateway.
Yeah.
But before that, Nicole and I are doing a show this Friday night in Freeport. On a cruise.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, it's the Mystery Port 5V.
Awesome.
And leaves dock at 7 p.m. If you want to go, it's 85 Woodcliff Avenue, Freeport, New York. The phone number to call is 516-378-0555. And
get yours now. The tickets are running out.
Is that a dinner show?
Yes.
Oh, great.
You can't beat that. A beautiful night out on the water.
And if you guys bomb, they throw you all if you didn't call. Is that what happens?
You're going to get drunk.
To the show.
No, you guys are going to kill.
I'm going to get drunk and just start barfing. If they want to throw me over, I'm going to just...
Great read, Ben. That'll get him calling.
If you'll be overboard, I'm going to be like, can I still use his plate to get the rest of the game?
And... Gateway Comedy Presents.
That's right.
On August 21st.
I had nothing to do with this. I had
nothing. On a Friday. The Old Bastards of Comedy.
That's right.
The Old Bastards of Comedy.
Bastards.
I am hosting that show.
Great.
Stevie Jeebies on that show. We have a
bunch of other guys. Greg Rayner and Greg, help me.
D'Agostino,
George D'Agostino, right? And Les Deegan, I don't want to forget anybody.
Remember names. I'm
60 years old. Doesn't remember names. He's got a talk show, and he doesn't remember.
You guys sit in the chairs there, whoever you people are.
All right. We were going to show, speaking of Stevie GB, we were going to show Stevie GB's entry for the video contest. But I say, fuck it.
I say the same thing. Fuck him.
I'm sure Stevie's watching us right now. Please.
Fuck you, Stevie.
We'll show it to you next week, Stevie.
Next week, Stevie.
Exactly.
Look at Nicole, if we get to it.
If we get to it.
He's
if
the
we
if you
feel
get to
like
it.
Getting to it.
He's got the worst of being the if you get to it segment.
We're going to have some
There's like about five of them on my show if we get to it.
Joe, what do you have? Anyway, Gateway has something almost every Friday night.
Saturday the 22nd, we also have an open mic night.
Clarion
with,
Hotel.
Talia Reese and also Mike Keegan is doing it.
I'm gonna come down. I'm gonna go. Mike
come on
Keegan.
Down. And we try to give newer comics a chance. You know what I mean?
And this is at the Clarion Hotel on Veterans Highway in Bohemia.
Ronkonkoma.
Ronkonkoma. It's like the border. Yeah.
Across the street and get run over. The guy died in Ronkonkoma, but the guy died in Bohemia. Who cares? He's dead. He crossed the street like an asshole. They ran him over. Okay, Ronkonkoma, the coroner. But Ronkonkoma, Bohemia, come on.
Half of them is running.
The guy is dead. What does it matter where he died?
Like right now. You're sitting in Ronkonkoma, your legs are Bohemia.
Yeah, exactly. How many people can say that? My leg will be appearing at Applebee's this afternoon. I will be over in the TGIF. At the same time, you figure out the fucking mess. All right.
Joe, what do you have going on?
Actually, not much the next couple weeks. However, I'm on a show called Davin's Den.
Yes.
Davinsden.com. We are on every Tuesday from 6:30 to 9:30, so you could watch this show first, watch the Gagoot show first, and then go to Davinsden.com, click Listen Live, and then you are in every Tuesday. 6:30, 9:30 Eastern Standard Time.
And it's a great show. I've worked with both of them, Davin, and a great comic, and Joe, of course, a great comic. Great show, Joe.
And it's
Thank you.
Scam. You scam
the scammers.
What we do, we scam. They're like all these internet romance scammers. Matter of fact, one wrote to me today And I'm like, I'm very lonely. I'd like to meet you, and hopefully we'll be
horsing around. In fact, Joe actually.
That'd be great.
In fact, Joe actually had me on the show a couple weeks ago, scamming comedy clubs. He said, "You son of a bitch!
Oh,
you call yourself."
Anyway, we have to say goodbye. We had a lot of fun.
Oh yeah,
thank absolutely. You guys for coming. Thanks. I hope
thanks
you come back.
You guys, thank you for having thank us. Thank you.
Guys,
great.
Give me
have
my,
a great week.
Give me
everybody.
My fucking leg back now.
Yeah.
No.
America has to put it back in the
show. Yeah, America, my good friend chauffeur.
All right, thank you everybody. Have a great
night,
weekend.
Everybody.
We'll see you next week.
See you next week.
All right. Okay, let's blow this.